deadline that was imposed. And a lot of stuff has happened, right?
Right.
So we're gonna talk about some of it. Right now, I want to let everybody know my name is Justice. I've been organizing with Dream Fighters Coalition along with Alex. We started this up when number 45 decided that some folks don't belong here. And we say that they do. I want to actually, come on up here, Nathan. We are going to help carry the program tonight. I'm going to turn it over here to my comrade to introduce himself.
My name is Nathan Hernandez. I'm helping out KS Moda. I'm part of Resist Hate KC. Thank you guys for being here tonight. Can I hear you guys? Make some noise. Yeah.
I want to make sure that everybody here is on the same page. Right now, we're harnessing the spirit of unity. That's what's needed right now. Our brothers and sisters, our undocumented brothers and sisters, our immigrant families all across Kansas and Missouri need to know that we are here with them. You need to show. They need to feel it. Because it's been tough for them. It's been real hard. So I want to get us ready right now to enter into that space of unity, that space of solidarity. And I want to ask Diana. I don't see you. But I want you to come up and talk about the significance of the candles that you see tonight.
Okay, so I am going to speak about the significance of the candles. So if you guys could please hold them up so we can all see them. And I'm also going to introduce myself. My name is Anna, and I am a DACA recipient. I am a member of the Kansas Missouri Dream Alliance. I am also a graduate student at the University of Kansas. I've been living in the U.S. for the past 15 years. The candles we're holding signify the number of DACA recipients that lose protections every day. Every day, 122 DACA recipients are stripped from their status and ability to legally work whatsoever. We are like the flowers that never get water but still blossom. We will not let Trump or Stephen Miller take away what we have worked very hard for. Now, we have a Congress that lacks leadership and a backbone and are too afraid to stand up to this administration and their nationalist agenda. Because of this system, makes money off of every immigrant that is held in a detention facility. Because they prefer that we remain in the shadow, paying us less than minimum wage as we pay taxes and help build this country. We are construction workers as we are educators. We are domestic workers as we are nurses. They are afraid that we will run for office one day and take their seats. They are afraid of us. This is why we need a Dream Act, so we no longer live in fear and uncertainty. We need protection so that our families can stay together. There are thousands of undocumented young folks that were too young to apply for DACA at the time and currently have zero protection. And that's a privilege that I do have that others don't. Now, our elected officials have turned their back on us and refused to stand up to celebrity apprentice Trump, but we will show them what leadership looks like.
That's right.
Yes.
Our parents taught us how to fight, and our experiences have made us resilient. We will fight like hell here in KC and in DC to protect our communities. And we will remember who stood with
against us in the upcoming elections.
That's right.
And we will hold them accountable.
That's right.
We will not be used as bargain chips or as a political puppet. We refuse to turn our backs on our parents, TPS holders, our Muslim brothers and sisters, and our undocumented Black community. We are undocumented, unafraid, and we are here to stay.
Here to stay!